Howdy, folks, and welcome to Tiny Tent Show episode number 40. It's amazing. This show will consist of samples of some of our favorite clips and performances from the year that shall not speak its name. We thank you so much for your support, past, present, and future. There is a Donate Now link live in the comments section as this show is unfolding. You can also, of course, contact Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua offices and make a donation through those more formal channels if you prefer. And we'd also ask that you rebroadcast this show on your social media channels if you get the opportunity. We can joke and roll our eyes about the year 2020. That kind of humor is how we survive around these parts, whether we're in the ditch or in the middle of a pandemic. But this has also been a year of true loss. Losses of the sort that deserve a quiet moment of reflection. The Big Top family, performers, volunteers, employees, and the fans who fill the seats, they make up a big family. And a widespread family, and we know there have been losses in that family which we know nothing about, of which we are unaware or yet to learn. And if this is so, we wish you comfort in this moment. We'd also like to take a moment right now to honor several members of the Big Top family who left us from the end of 2019 to the present.
This new disease sure hurts the heart. I wonder how long we can last. Are all the good times really in the past? Everyone's a getting hard to have some fun. As everything comes crashing down, you say your prayers in hope that God is still there. Stranger, just hold on tight. We'll find the fracture in the night. Oh, stranger, you'll be all right. And through the cracks we'll see the light.
So many memories, so many lives. Folks, this New Year's Day show is our 40th episode. Originally, we figured we would share highlights from shows 1 through 39. But like Rockhounds, does everybody remember Rockhounds? I was really into being a Rockhound when I was little. I had the polisher for the rocks. It sat on top of the piano and it spun and spun and spun. Went to some of the meetings too and might have even had a patch or something like that. But anyway, like rockhounds returning to our favorite hunting spot, when we got done picking and choosing through all those episodes, the pockets in our cargo pants were filled to overflowing. So tonight, we are going to share some gems from episodes 1 through 19. And then next week, we will share those from episodes 20 through 39. According to Ed Willett, you might want to save some of those sparkly drinks you're breaking out tonight for January 8th, because at Tiny Tent Show, this will be New Year's week. All right, so set the Wayback Machine to April. Is it only since April? This year has been a dang lifetime. Anyway, away we go.
If you've ever come to the Big Top and seen Tom Mitchell perform, you know he's always willing to go that extra mile to entertain. And today is no exception. In the following video, Tom will... you know, just have a look.
Hello, I'm Tom Mitchell. I'm about to attempt something that has never before been attempted or successfully achieved in the history of humanity. I'm going to play a harmonica, chugging rhythmic train solo while brushing a fine-haired dog. Ready?
Thanks, Tom. I think a special thank you also to Brady, who was the dog not harmed in that sketch, but I don't know that he signed any waivers either. So our next guest is not just a friend of the tent, she's part of the tent family, part of the Blue Canvas Orchestra family, here tonight to sing a song by Joni Mitchell, Yasmin.
Hey, everybody. Good to see you all again. I'm going to be playing in honor of Earth Day, a classic Joni Mitchell tune, which I'm sure you all recognize. Hope you like it. Pay paradise, put up a parking lot with a pink hotel, a boutique, a swinging hot spot. Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you've got till it's gone? Pay paradise, build up a parking lot. Bum, 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 shoo, bum, 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 bum. Take all the trees, put them in a tree museum, and you charge the people a dollar and a half just to see them. You've got till it's gone. Pay paradise, put up a parking lot. Bum, 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 shoo, bum, 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 bum. Pay from a farmer, put away the DDT now. Give me spots on my apples, but maybe the birds and the bees. Please, don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you've got till it's gone. Pay paradise, put up a parking lot. Paradise, put up a parking lot. Pay paradise, put up a parking lot. Ooh, pa, 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 pa. Pay paradise, put up a parking lot.
Yasmin, everyone. Pleasure to have her singing with us. Around the Bayfield Peninsula is a rare archipelago of 21 islands, established in 1970 as the Apostle Islands National Lakeshore, a gorgeous national park home to the largest single collection of historic lighthouses in the country. Today, the remaining lights are automated, whereas for over 100 years, they were manned by lightkeepers and their families. The next song, Keeper of the Light, honors those people in that time with music by Warren Nelson and words drawn from keepers' journals, letters, interviews, and other primary source material, all illustrated with historically accurate photos from both public and private collections curated by Betty Ferris. The song was created in 1985 as part of Riding the Wind, the first show ever performed on the Big Top stage and a central feature of every Chautauqua season since.
I'm the keeper of the light on Michigan Island. Candle in the night for the steamboat trade, with an eye on the wick and a whistle to the ships that are bound for the bay, a runner for a leak.
I'm the keeper of the light on Michigan Island. A candle in the night for the steamboat trade, with an eye on the wick and a whistle to the ships that are bound for the bay, a runner for a leak.
My mother took the oath of office, and we packed our family. We sailed with open water for a season of the dynasty. We live by regulation, but tell it all instead. We clean our hands and lanterns that were lightships on the way. We rock the brass and shine the brass, and then we polish brass. We wound the clock that turned the night, and then we swept the tower. And we fished in tender flower beds and sang.
I'm a keeper of the light on Long Island, the candle in the night for the steamboat trade, with an eye on the wick and a whistle to the ships that are bound for the bay, a runner for a lee.
Bend Island light was a brownstone tower, and the light most westerly, lit in 1881, for the South Shore steamer lane. Down bound from the head of the lake, the mariners could not see. The island shoals we could run them aground, they couldn't see the light at Raspberry. One dark night, Keeper Lewis rose to trim the light. September 2nd, 1905, the storm had blown all night. Through a glassy spy, the Savona, strike a reef and break. 17 made the shore, 7 swallowed by the lake.
I'm the keeper of the light on Sand Island, the candle in the night for the steamboat trade, with an eye on the wake and a whistle to the ships that are bound for the bay, a runner for a lee.
Back to Outer Island Station we came, with the visions and the mail. At 4 o'clock, the wind commenced, it blew a living gale. We lit the land at sunset, afraid the clock would break. Well, then it knew it blew a hurricane, the tower began to shake. It was damp in the land and freezing, the oil all congealed. We were scrubbing with brine on the lantern glass to remove the angry sea. Our dock was driven to the boulders, to talk we had to shout. So splendid was Superior's fury, 25 miles out.
I'm a keeper of the light on Outer Island, the candle in the night for the steamboat trade, with an eye on the wick and a whistle to the ships that are bound for the bay, a runner for a lee.
Thank you.
of old Michigan town. The first apostle light with the station at Shagawamig. We watched the South Channel, but the strongest play to the youngest. And a turning point on the lake. You can see the devil beam 18 miles an hour away.
We lived in an era the time was past. As deep as we were friends. Who's gonna fill the last tonight and shine that better land? If we could gather at Raspberry in our tenders, we would go. I hear the steamers come arounding and the longboard whistle blow. I'm a keeper of the line on Raspberry Island, a captain in the night for the steamboat trade with an eye on the wick and a whistle to the ships that are bound for the bay. We're running for a lee. I'm a keeper of the line on Raspberry Island, a captain in the night for the steamboat trade with an eye on the wick and a whistle to the ships that are bound for the bay. Down for the bay, running for a lead.
Well, folks, earlier this year, on this very show, world-class musician Randy Sabin embarked on a 30-day music tour of his house. And then the tour got extended. Now, the last time we checked in on him, Randy was holding up real well. It was clear that even in these tough times, his music sustains him. And he always gives me a real boost and our audience a real boost. So let's check in on him now, see how things are going.
Kitchen. Sorry I'm late. Guess you've already helped yourself to the mimosas, I see. And today's special. Today's special is, I guess it's aged oatmeal. If you want it heated up, I guess you could do that for you. Gonna play some music for you.
You want to go over there and check on Randy? I mean, I wouldn't go in the house, just crack a window, maybe poke him with a stick. Well, we're clearly all dealing with these difficult times in our own way. Ed Willett, for instance, has taken to playing in the streets, although only a city kid from L.A. would call a dirt road a street.
Hey, everybody. Ed Willett here. As you can see, I'm on the road again. Today, I'd like to talk to you about a real problem that we have in Highbridge, Wisconsin, where I live, and that's traffic. The traffic is unbearable, and I just don't know what to do with it. I moved from Los Angeles just to get away from traffic, but it's every bit as bad here. Every bit. Well, I left Highbridge about 5 o'clock. It took me 15 minutes to go 3 blocks. Just in time to wait in line with the freeway looking like a parking lot. I said, damn, this traffic jam. How I hate to be late. It hurts my motor to go so slow. Time to get home, my sip will be cold. Well, damn, this traffic jam. Damn. Damn. Every bit is bad. Every bit is bad. Well, I almost had a heart attack. I was looking in my rearview mirror. Well, I saw myself the next car back. I was looking in my rearview mirror. Well, I'm about to have a heart attack. I said, damn, this traffic jam. How I hate to be late. Hurts my motor to go so slow. time I get home, my supper be cold. Well, damn this traffic jam, damn. Oh no, no, not another hay wagon. No, no, turn, ah, turn. Now when I die, I don't want no coffin. I thought about it all too often. Just strap me in behind the wheel and bury me with my automobile. Damn this traffic jam, how I hate to be late. It hurts my motor to go so slow. Time I get home, my supper will be cold. Well, damn this traffic jam. Damn. I'm moving now, though. I'm really moving now. Oh, no. No, not a school bus. Please, not a school bus. Oh no, the red lights, the blinking red lights. Oh no. Well, I used to think that I was cool running around on fossil fuel. And then I found what I was doing was driving down the road to ruin. Hey, get out of the way!
It would appear that Ed has taken his hands off the metaphorical wheel. Maybe he can hitch a hay wagon ride over to Randy's and they can work it out together.
Folks, true performers will set up shop or stage anywhere you give them a chance, and this next clip proves it. Two in a Canoe is a piece that was written by Warren Nelson. It was part of the Big Top show Wild River, which celebrated the designation of the St. Croix River as a protected, wild, and scenic river. It is performed for us in the following clip by Randy Sabine and Jan Lee. Ahoy.
How can I feel so free and easy? How come you look so much like you back there? All day, you never lose it. To be carried along like a child on this wild river way. My soul has gone to my shoulder. I'm pulling on the upper St. Croix. I'm back in the water, saddle paddle, two in a canoe. Well, the water's low this year. We better put in at Riverside. Round the first bend, already it's another world. But on which side of this island, looking for a channel, better go with the flow. Even in this drought, listen to the St. Croix sing. We'll camp at Little Yellow Banks tonight. Have a fire and a nip, sing some cowboy songs. Well, you can pay a psychiatrist $100 an hour just to spit your troubles to. Or you can take a week off work, rent a canoe, and shut up. How can I feel so free and easy? How come you look so much like you back there? All day you never lose it. To be carried along like a child on this wild river way. My soul has gone to my shoulder. I'm pulling on the upper St. Croix. I'm back in the water, saddle paddle, doing a canoe. There in that cooler for a breakfast on the river. If we had some eggs, we could have some ham and eggs if we had some ham. Well, let's start with a jolt of camp coffee. Should I or do you want to do it? Pour too many scoops in a boiling pot. Stir it, smell it, chew it. Ah, then we'll slide out, glide, ride the river down. We'll tip a hat to all the tributaries coming in. And then a week from now in bed, the sound of these rapids will be still running through my head, rushing my dreams along. Who do we thank? Who do we pay for saving this winding waterway? It's an answer to a prayer said way back there 30 years ago. Well, it's our day now in the July sun, but for all the children yet to come, it's a gift, a blessing, a memory, a main thing. I can't get to sleep. I'm starlit moon-eyed wild. Tell those otters I want to come to their party. I want to move through the water saves. The best that I can do is to wake up in the morning mist with you two in a canoe. How can I feel so free and easy? How come you look so much like you back there all day? You never lose it to be carried along like a child on this wild river way. Yeah. My soul is gone to my shoulder. I'm pulling on the upper St. Croix. I'm back in the water, saddle paddle, two in a canoe. Oh, my soul is gone in my shoulder. I'm pulling on the upper St. Croix. I'm back in the water, saddle paddle, two in a canoe.
Two in a canoe, in honor of the St. Croix River. May she ever run wild. So last week, we were witness to an exchange between Ole and Sven, and based on their behavior, I wondered aloud if anybody had checked in on Lena. Well, good news, folks.
Oh, hey, hi, how are ya? Oh, it's good to see ya. You know, just between us, I am having the time of my life. This COVID-19 is a little bit of a blessing in disguise for me, don't you know? I sent Ole to the garage about a month ago, and lo and behold, I clean the house, it stays clean. Nobody's asking me where things are, and the best part, I haven't had to clean a fish in over a month. Now, of course, you don't have to share that with Ole, right? You know, I'm sure he's pretty down and fairly miserable without me.
For the first time in over 40 years, I'm a happily married man.
But I had a great aunt once in the 1960s, and she got pneumonia. Now, of course, she recovered from it. But I'm pretty sure that leaves me with a predisposed condition. Or at least that's what I'm telling Ole.
I started watching some YouTube videos. Oh my goodness. They've got everything under the sun in that their channel. You can learn how to do anything. They call them DIY videos. Yeah. That was the initial of my first boyfriend, Dagmar Ivan Janssen. Mm-hmm. It stands for do it yourself, which is funny because that's what Ole says to me every time I ask him to do a chore.
You know, nowadays it's so important to wear masks when you go outside. It protects you and it protects your neighbors too. And that doesn't mean that you can't be stylish while you're wearing one. Looky here. It's a Stormy Cromer mask, straight from the factory. Aren't they lovely? They come in two colors, blue plaid and red plaid. I got the blue one so it would match my eyes, and I got Ole the red one for the same reason.
You know what else is important? Self-care. That's right, we need to take care of ourselves and make sure that we're happy and healthy in this difficult time. So you know what I did? I pulled out my grandma's good glasses, you know, the ones in back that we never use, and I poured in some wine, and I felt so fancy, I decided to put on my good fancy glasses and have a little drink. So I do that every day, and it makes such a difference. So cheers to you, and to you, Lena. Cheers.
Well, I guess things could be going worse. Honestly, they both seem to be thriving. Or as we say around here, thriving. Tom Mitchell and Ed Willett may be safer at home, but that doesn't stop them from making some music together this week. And here they are now, syncing up on their rendition of All Along the Watchtower.
There must be some way out of here, said the Joker to the thief. There is too much confusion, I can't get no relief. Businessmen, they drink my wine, plowmen dig my earth, but none of them along my line knows what any of it is worth. Spoke. There are many here among us who feel that life is a joke. But you and I, we've been through that, and this is not our fate. So let us not talk falsely now.
Tom Mitchell and Ed Willett snuck little Beatles in there, if I'm not mistaken. Well, now I take myself to the woodshed to think about birds.
Howdy, folks. Well, I'm hunkered down in the woodshed here. I was going to do this piece outside because it's an essay about birds and bird song, but it is tumultuously windy out there, so I've come for a little shelter in the woodshed, and we'll just read about the birds, and maybe you can hear those. I don't know. You also, if you listen really closely, you will catch the sound of a chicken or two. This morning, the gray rainscape was brightened by the sight of a dusky red mother cardinal pecking across the driveway outside my window. She was flanked by a pair of birds her same size. They were tan and of similar configuration. It took me a moment to realize they were her offspring. The clincher came when she turned toward one and it gawped its face wide open. The mother popped her beak down the youngster's gullet and deposited whatever it was she had pecked off the damp pavement. On she hopped and on she pecked, her children tagging close behind. Every few feet she stopped, turned, and stuffed one or the other maw. In light of their size, the younger birds looked ludicrous not fending for themselves. I was reminded of adolescents wandering helplessly through a well-stocked kitchen, waiting for hamburgers to drop from the light sockets and string cheese to pour out the faucets. I may or may not have some
teenager raising experience. It lightened my heart to see the youngsters thriving, however. Last year, a robin laid eggs in a nest not 3 feet off the ground in a spruce tree down by the pole barn. And while my younger daughter enjoyed checking the eggs, she got a dose of cold nature when a windstorm upended the whole works before hatching, leaving nothing but a frayed nest and chips of eggshell blue in the grass. Another robin has nested in the yard this year, a good 15 feet up in a young but sturdy maple. I can't see the eggs, but I can see her up there resolutely set. So far, so good. Then there were the wrens who built a nest in my office window, packing a narrow space between the sill and air conditioner with sticks and pine needles, and, I am told by the internet, spider egg sacks. Excuse me while I check my office chair and shudder. It was a bad place for a nest, but they had it well homesteaded by the time I discovered them, and over the next few weeks I came to love their burbling song, such bright noise from such brown birds. Although I had to work hot, because every time I turned the air conditioner on, Mama Wren fled. I'd rather be sweaty than guilty, and so I rationed my cool downs. 2 days later, I heard a thump and the wrens scolding. When I exited the office, a cat was hanging by both forepaws from the windowsill. The nest was pulled apart, and a barely feathered wren chick was weakly weaving its wings. Before I could intervene, the chick was eaten. The following day, I hung a wren house within view of the office window. Amends, I suppose, or hope. I enjoyed writing to Wren Song, and I hope I may again. Birds and baby birds in springtime are a lesson in acceptance. Nature makes no investment in care or kindness. Your garden variety bird survives on determination and chance. The father cardinal and his bright red feathers, for whatever reason, are nowhere to be seen. I'm happy to report that I did see a father cardinal around again this year. And also, I hung that wren house, and that's been 3 years now since I wrote that piece. And every year, that wren house has been occupied, and they were singing out there this morning. So nature works it all out. Sometimes our job is just to stay out of the way. Oh, and also this year they started building a nest in between the windowsill and the air conditioner, and I felt bad, but I just cleared the sticks out before they even really got started, and did so for a couple of days, and then they moved over another 4 feet and built a nest in the wren house. So sometimes you do interfere with nature. Anyway, it's a beautiful day out here, and it's a pleasure to be sharing our thoughts and stories with all of you out there, and we're grateful for what you do to keep us going.
Well, now it's time to truly kick off New First Night, and we'll do that with a song that was written by Warren Nelson, and it has launched the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua season for years and years now. It's called Ballyhoo, and man, you gotta sing that chorus so that everybody in quarantine can hear you.
I can't believe another year's gone around. Is that a big top we see there lying on the ground? Ballyhoo. Ah, ballyhoo. My big tent bag rolling in the sun. What we have here is a half ton of fun. Ballyhoo. Ah, ballyhoo. Pull it up, lace it up, snap off the stakes. My heart starts to flutter, my soul starts to shake. Ballyhoo. Ah, ballyhoo. To the Chautauqua tent show, back it up, let's go. 8:15, old circus time. Never seen such a sight on a sweet summer night. All canvas, music, magic, and light. It's big, it's blue, it's big top show time for me and you. Ballyhoo.
Sponsors, we'd like to thank Jim and Joy Perry, Jim and Joanne Collins, Star North Cornucopia, Brownstone Pharmacy, Washburn, the Ashland Daily Press, Big Top Friends, the Bujolds, Manleys, Sandstroms, and Roths, Myra Ainert, Movement Matters, Janet Sternett, Bayfield.
To the Chautauqua Tent Show, pack it up, let's go, 8:15, old circus time. Never seen such a sight on a sweet summer night. All canvas, music, magic, delight. It's big, it's blue, it's big time show time for me and you. Ballyhoo, oh, ballyhoo.
Out there.
The Blue Canvas Orchestra, the BCO, raising a ballyhoo with Philip Anich on the lead vocals.
And now for something completely different. We're approaching the summer solstice here. And here's your science lesson from the day, compliments of Monty Python. Just imagine that you're standing on a planet that's evolving, revolving at 900 miles an hour. It's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned the sun that is the source of all our power. The sun and you and me and all the stars that we can see are moving at 1,000,000 miles a day. In an outer spiral arm at 40,000 miles an hour of the galaxy we call the Milky Way. Our galaxy itself contains 100 billion stars. It's 100,000 light years side to side. It bulges in the middle, 13,000 light years thick, but out by us it's just 3,000 light years wide. With 30,000 light years from galactic central point, we go round every 200 million years. And our galaxy is just one of millions of billions in this amazing and expanding universe. The universe itself keeps on expanding and expanding in all of the directions it can whiz. As fast as you can go, the speed of light, you know, 12 million miles a minute, and that's the fastest speed there is. So remember when you're feeling very small and insecure, how amazingly unlikely was your birth. And pray that there's intelligent life somewhere out in space. 'Cause there's bugger all down here on Earth. Happy solstice.
In keeping with that memory, here is a song performed by today's BCO, a song written by Ed Willett. Just a song written of and for Bruce.
I win, tails I lose. I'm late for my supper, and there's holes in my shoes. Time won't forgive me, won't slow its hand. Still, I can't help thinking I'm a fortunate man. And we're all on our way to that heavenly session. We'll get to play in that heavenly band. So save me a seat between you and Hank Williams. We'll play it to our lessons and blow us on the your soul, you can step right on in. Yeah, if music's your soul, you can step right on in.
Holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard. You gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. Gotta be cool, gotta be calm, we gotta stay together. All I know, love will save the day. Herald what your mother said, read the books your father read. Try and solve the puzzles in your own sweet time. Some may have more cash than you, others take a different view. My, oh my. Yeah, you gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. Gotta be hard, gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know, love save the day. Now, don't ask no questions, life goes on without you. If you can't stand the craze, no. The world keeps on spinning, can't stop it if you try to. The best part is danger staring you in the face. Remember, listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. My, oh my, yeah, yeah. You gotta be bad, gotta be bold, you gotta gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. Gotta be cool, gotta be calm, we gotta stay together. All I know, love save the day, yeah, yeah. You got to be bold, you got to be bad, you got to be wise, but don't ever say. You got to be hard, but not too hard. All I know is love will save the day, yeah. Gotta be wiser, we gotta be stronger. Oh, oh, yes, we do. All of us do. Yeah. All I know is love will save the day.
Keep fighting for change. Be bold, be bad, be wiser. Love will save the day.
We continue to honor Jeff now with a flashback provided courtesy of Wisconsin Public Television. The footage you're about to see is from a special on Randy Sabine and the Fiddlehead Band. And if you watch closely in the back there, you'll see Jeff Eccles joyfully and intensely at work on his beloved bass.
Thank you.
Money from a Stranger, featuring Randy Sabine and on bass, Jeffrey Eccles.
The next three tunes are from Back to the Garden, a special big top show about Woodstock. Your performers are Molly Otis, Ed Willett, Severin Bainan, Tom Mitchell, and Nate Bean.
This next song was written by George Harrison, and I was looking this up. It is the most requested Beatles song on streaming devices, and through the pandemic, that went through the roof, the requests for it. So I thought that was really interesting, and what I realized was it's a song that's hopeful and grateful, and I guess we all need a little bit of that right now. It comes a sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. It comes a sun, they say, it's all right. Little darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it feels like years since you've been.
Thank you.
They are. They are. They're waving at us. Hey, nice. That's good.
We know you're out there. We know you're out there.
I like your line, Molly, before. I've played to a lot of audiences that haven't reacted, so this is no problem.
I'm used to it.
Yeah. We're going to go on with a title cut from the Woodstock show with a little tune called Woodstock. Oh. Yeah. How did we ever come up with this stuff? It's just, it's intense. But anyway, yeah, we're going to do this tune a little differently than we do in the show. We thought we'd give you a little bit of a new look at this guy. Here it comes. Upon the child of God, he was walking along the road, and I asked him, tell me, where are you going? Said, I'm going down to Yesgar's farm, gonna join in a rock and roll band. Got to get back to the land and set my soul free. We are stardust, we are golden, we are billion-year-old carbon, and we've got to get ourselves back to the God.
And I run beside you, can I come to lose a small? And I feel myself and something's turning inside me. Maybe it's the time of year. Yeah, maybe it's the time of man. I don't know who I am, but life is learning.
We are stardust, we are golden, we are millions.
Well, the next song we have for you here is called Autumn Fancy. It's one of the most popular songs that Warren Nelson has written. You may remember we've done it at Apple Fest so many times where it's so perfectly fitting.
The lake hills turn the color of a fox's coat. Easy in the breeze, the leaves go float. When the birch burn yellow and the maple red, the apples are ripe up overhead. When the fall is falling all around, get your wood up quick, winter coming to town. The way the Indian summer lays on the bay this fine October day. Blue in the big lake, blue in the sky, blue down the river of the time gone by. Green come the summer to golden end, yellow is the eye of a herd, my friend.
September winds are a sailor's charm, the new moon's up in the old moon's arms. Up the little river go the trout to spawn. You can see your breath rise in the dawn. Come early frost, the summer people go back to our old sails, broke and slow. There's a harvest moon we dance around when the garden's in the jar. Ah, blue in the big lake, blue in the sky, blue down the river of a time gone by. Green come a summer to a golden end, yellow is the eye over earth, my friend.
Come gray November, the month of gales, Superior sings her shipwreck tales. And the waves that beat and pound the shore light your home fire now and close the door. When the geese are honking high in a V, and the boat's such a naked as a bottle tree. By Thanksgiving Day and the herring run, be done with all you started. Blue in the big lake, blue in the sky, blue down the river all the time gone by. Green come a summer to a golden end, yellow is the eye of a red-eyed friend. Summer to a golden end, yellow is the eye over earth, my friend. The lake hills turn the color of a fox's coat. Easy in the breeze, the leaves go cold. When the birch burn yellow and the maple red, and the apples are ripe up overhead. When the fall is falling all around, get your wood up quick, winter coming to town. The way the Indian summer lays on the bay this fine October.
Corey Carlson is a lifetime member of the Big Top family. This next song is a poignant look at the emotional ride that this pandemic has been putting us all through. It is a Corey Carlson original, and it's called Stranger.
day apart. This new disease sure hurts the heart. I wonder how long we can last. Are all the good times really in the past? Getting hard to have some fun. As everything comes crashing down, you say your prayers and hope that God is still there. Stranger, just hold on. Fracture in the night, oh stranger, you'll be alright, and through the cracks we'll see the light. Time he wants a little more. He's wearing every face in town. It could be you to give your friend the blues, oh stranger. Just hold on tight. Sure, in the night, oh stranger, you'll be all right, and through the cracks we'll see the light. Do you remember the night you stayed so close together? This new disease sure hurts the heart. As everything comes crashing down, you say your prayers in hope that God is still there. Stranger, just hold on. In the night, oh stranger, you'll be all right, and through the cracks we'll see the light, oh stranger, just hold on tight, we'll find the fracture in the night, oh stranger.
A while back, we invited you to join our choir. It's kind of a strange request in these times, but we found a way. You found a way. So here we go. Here you go, singing Lean on Me, the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua Tiny Tent Show Virtual Choir. Take it away, Severin.
Baby, love, you are the best. Happy New Year.
Our favorite memory was Randy Sabine and his broadcasting, when he went on tour with his shows.
Yeah. I thought it was such a clever idea that he performed from each room in his house. It was one of those, I wish I would have thought of that moments.
And cheers.
And cheers.
My favorite memory of Tiny Tent Show this summer was being on my deck, looking out over into the valley and the hills beyond, being under a tiny tent with a blue top, listening to the Blue Canvas Orchestra play the Beatles, singing at the top of my lungs, and having the cows across the road in the dairy barn join in along with me.
Greetings from South Milwaukee. We love the Tiny Tent Show. We've watched every episode, and we will continue watching as long as the Tiny Tent Show continues. We hope to be back to the Big Top this summer. We love the variety of music, the storytelling, but especially the interviews with the musicians. We feel we've gotten to know them better and wish them the very best. And thank you for being the anchor to our week every Friday night.
Tiny Tent Show staff and Lake Superior Big Top. Goodness, I wish I were there. Favorite moments, Tom Mitchell trying to play music on his dog, Randy Sabine's concerts in his bathrobes throughout his house and on the front porch, cracked me up. Michael Perry, what can I say? Wonderful storyteller and good interviewer. Jack Gunderson, Phil Anish, everyone. It's just been such a great diversity of music and a pleasure to listen to on these otherwise dark and dreary days. Although here at my house in South Milwaukee, it's great. Thank you, Tiny Tent Show.
Happy New Year, Big Top community from Deb Lewis in Ashland, Wisconsin. I miss you all so much. Thank you so much for bringing Tiny Tent Show this past year. You have all been a warm blanket on Friday nights. Big Top is all about community, and you all have been week after week a touchstone and a safe harbor during our pandemic year. My favorite part of the season was all of the interviews that Michael Perry did with all of you. It's been wonderful to hear your stories, to hear about how you got into music and how you came to the Big Top. Bless you all. Watch out, 2021, here we come. Woohoo!
Well, folks, that's our Tiny Tent Show for tonight. Tune in next week for the second half of the year's memories. Thank you, and thank you to our sponsors. Jim and Joy Perry, Ringenberg Financial Group, Mary Lou and Pat Irvine, Peggy and Ed Callahan, Cole F. Nichols, ADPA, of Edward Jones in Ashland, Roger and Sharon Shaver, Northern State Bank. If you can join these sponsors, we hope that you will consider it. There is a Donate Now button live right now in the comments section. And of course, you can always, as I tell you, contact the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua offices and make a donation through those channels. Until we can sell tickets to the real deal, this is what enables us to bring you this tiny version. We miss you. We look forward to seeing you again. And we will see this thing through. In these times, more than ever, we thank you for your time and your attention. We hope you're taking good care of yourself, taking care of your neighbors, and that they're doing the same for you. And now, the time has come not to bid you adieu or say goodbye, but rather to say, well, I suppose, forward.